Hi everyone, my name is Abel Greg Antoma. I'm from Greater Scott Design Concept. This is my WhatsApp contact. You can reach me on this number, you can call me, okay? Today I'm going to be showing you how to actually come about your cross-section in your civil 3D. Let's jump right into it. Okay, so to get our cross-section, the first thing we'll do is to come to our sample line, okay? Sample line will actually in your sample line, you will be able to specify the distance between one cross section to another cross section. That is, you want to specify at what interval you want your cross section to be created. Okay, so I'll click on sample line, and then you can see it says I should select an alignment. Okay, so the alignment which I actually created from the beginning, I'll just click on it and then I'll right click. Now you can see this window that has actually popped up with the name of this alignment that I just selected right now. Just gonna click on OK, and then you can see sample line tool. I can give this a name, okay, but I'm just gonna leave that as this. Now I'm going to use by range of stations, okay? So here you can see we have left sword width. The width it will cover, my cross section will cover. I'm going to make it 50. And then here too I'll make it 50, the right and the left, okay. And then here at 25 25, I'm going to leave it as it is. So it's going to give me a cross section of this road at each chainage of 25 meters, okay. So I'll click on OK. So I think that is actually loading in the background, so it's actually going to come up anytime soon. So you allow that to load, still loading. Okay, good. Click on enter, click on enter, click on enter. Now you can see those lines across this my road. That is where I'm going to be having those cross sections at this interval. So you can see the lines indicated there. So the informations are actually going to pop up once it's finished loading. Okay, so I will click on this. So I'm just going to click on one of this line, and then I'll create a section for that. I'll create multiple section. Okay. I can give this section a name. Let's say new road section. Go next. going to use draft. Okay, place section in a grid in model space. Sheet cannot be created using this option. So if I leave this here, it's actually going to use, you can see here, like a template for me to so all those sections will actually go into this template, but I don't want that, so I'm taking that off. So I'm going to be using this other option. I'll click on next here, click on next, data bound. Okay, so I'm going to leave it as major stations offset and elevation. Okay, so this is actually what is going to be displaying in your section. Okay, so if you leave it at no bound, you're just not going to get good informations there in your section. So I'm going to put it at major stations offset and elevation. So I'm going to see the offsets and the elevations at my section. Okay, so click on next and then I'll create section view. So I'm just going to look for where I have enough space in my window and I click there. Those cross sections are going to display at a change of 25 meters. So it's actually loading. So if you love what you have seen, why not like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel. It's actually 100% free. You see a red button down below written subscribe. Just click on that red button and you have subscribed already. Okay, click on the bell icon so as to get a notification whenever I post videos. I post videos like this on a weekly basis, sometimes on a daily, to encourage as many that actually want to have a deeper insight of design. Okay, so make sure you come register with us. You can pick my number down below in the description of this video. Okay, you'll find a link to our YouTube channel. Visit that channel and actually keep yourself busy. Okay, this is actually still loading. Good. Okay. Okay, it's still loading. Okay, I think it's okay now. Okay. Now you can see our road. This is actually our road. Okay, this is the daylight we used. And let's see. Now you can see the values for the existing elevation and then the proposed elevation. Okay, you can see the values there. The values are there. So you can compare between the proposed and then the existing. Okay. So this is actually how to get the cross section for this. But before I forget, let's go down to our corridor, because we did corridor before coming here. So if you check down your corridor here, on this new route, let's go to the properties of this corridor, and then come to your surface. So here, so I already have this here, but if you don't have that, you can just add that here. Okay, and then specify the code, the datum. Okay, I'm going to add my datum here. I'll come to my boundaries. Okay, on this, all right, click on this, go to daylight. Okay, so okay, I already have an existing daylight here, so just in case, remove boundary. So if you are not seeing this on your own, you can just add a daylight automatically But there's another way of doing it while you are actually doing your creating your corridor. Okay, so I just add this and I'm going to apply and I'll rebuild that corridor. Click on OK. So on the next episode, I'm going to be showing you how to get your quantity tables. Okay, you're going to see the volume and the area, and then you're going to see your cut and your fill. Okay, we are going to be generating that on the next episode of this series. Okay, so if you love what you're seeing, make sure you like this video, give it a thumbs up, okay? Subscribe to this channel, it's actually 100% free. Click on the bell icon so as to get a notification whenever I post videos. Post videos like this on a weekly, sometimes on a daily, to encourage as many that actually want to have a deeper insight to design, okay? Make sure that you stay safe and make sure that you stay blessed. It's actually still rebuilding that corridor. Once it's done with rebuilding that corridor, the changes will actually take effect on our design.